Hey guys, good morning. Welcome to yet another session of live DILR set solving. My name is Sunit and I do one set of DILR every day where I help you guys get a good start to the day by solving a DILR set. This is a recorded video, so I am going to be there in the chat live to help you out if you have any doubts. But yes, let's go ahead and do our set for the day today. My name is Sunit. As I said, I have done my engineering from IIT Delhi and my MBA from IIM Calcutta after I scored 100 percentile in CAT. Since graduating from IIM Calcutta, in the last 5.5 years, I have been teaching and I have my own startup which I work on. This is about Unacademy. There are a couple of subscription types on Unacademy. There's an iconic subscription where you get personal mentoring along with access to all lectures and courses. You can use the code SUNIT100 to get a 10% discount. CAT10 would also give you a 10% discount, or SUNIT100 or Sunit Live would also give you a 10% discount. So you can use that code. These are some of the batches which have recently started. So you could join in any of these batches. Great educators teaching you the entire curriculum from start to finish. There are workshops happening around the corner and tests as well. So just come on to the Unacademy application and take the complete advantage of these sessions happening over there. In terms of the subscription, there's discounts going on, or there's offers going on. On 12 months of subscription, you're getting 3 months free, and same for 24 months of subscription, you're getting another 3 months free. As I said, my code SUNITLIVE you can use to participate in the combat, which happens every Sunday on the Unacademy application at 12 o'clock. If you do well in the combat, you get certain discounts on your plus subscriptions. Okay, now before we come to the learnings, let's get going and solve the set for today. I realized that after yesterday's session, I did not show you the set that we are to do today. So let me first show the set to you completely. This is the set. Okay, this is the data given to you. This set seems to be on bar graphs. And this is the first question. This is the second question. Okay, you can just pause and play so that you guys can first solve the set and then you can see my solution or compare your solution with mine. Okay, these are the four questions I've shown to you. People who are already plus subscribed have access to all these sets and questions. So, aap logo se hopefully, I expect that you guys would have already solved these. But people who don't have access, this is the set and this is the question. So please pause and solve and then continue with the video. Right, so let's read now what is given over here. The bar graph shown below depicts the scores obtained by 6 test takers. Anshu, Saurabh, Suhail, Abhishek, Anand and Piyush in 10 topic based mocks numbered T1 to T10. The score for each participant represented in the graph is their score in the first and the last mock. Okay. Incidentally, it was also their minimum and maximum scores respectively. It was interestingly observed that the scores of all the participants showed a non-decreasing trend from the first mock to the last mock. Matlab increasing trend, matlab minimum to maximum ja raha. Also, for each participant, if all the different scores obtained by the participants are arranged, it would form an arithmetic progression with a single digit common difference. Also, for each participant, if all the different scores obtained by the participants are arranged, form an arithmetic progression with a single digit common difference. Okay, fair enough. Single digit common difference. Okay. What is the maximum number of tests in which Anshu could have scored, got the same score? The bar graph, okay, the score for it represents first and last mock, minimum and maximum also showed a non-decreasing trend if all the different scores are obtained. Okay, got it. A single digit common difference is possible. So what is the maximum number of tests in which Anshu could have got the same score? So let me just open the paint document. So Anshu's minimum is 16 and highest is 44. So I mean, common difference jitna jyada hoga, utte sare tests mein usko same marks aayenge. So the difference over here is 28, right? 24, yeah. So common difference can be 7. So 23, 30, 37 and 44. Right, so this is something that Anshu could have scored, and in one of the tests could have scored the same marks 6 times. So 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Sare tests bhi cover ho gaye aur 6 bar repeat bhi ho sakta hai. So maximum number of tests in which he could have got the same score is 6 tests, right? Because 10 tests in total, 5 different scores. So 1 test mein, sorry, 1 score 6 tests mein repeat aur baki 4 score 4 alag tests mein uske ho sakte. Maximum possible to wohi. How many different values of common difference can the different scores obtained by Anand in the mocks have? Anand. So Anand is going from 16 to 40. The difference is 24. So common difference of 2 not possible because 10 tests mein 24 ka difference nahi niklega. Common difference of 3 possible. Yes, 3 divides 24. 4 is possible. 6 is possible. 7 not possible. 8 is possible. 9 not possible. So 4 different values of common difference possible. 2 not possible. 3 ek baar check kar le. 16, 19, 22, 25, 28, 31, 34, 37, 40. Yes. So 9 tests mein ho raha aur koi ek test mein score repeat hoga. 2 kar lo to 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, 26, 28, 30, 32, 34 mein hi 10 test ho gaye to 40 tak main ja nahi paunga. So I have 4 such values of the common difference over here. So if you see over here, there's application of a bit of sequence and series in this particular test. How many of the 6 people could have got different scores in all the 10 tests? Different scores. So agar main Anshu dekhu, Anshu 2 nahi ho sakta, 4 ho sakta hai, 7 ho sakta hai. 4 hoga to 7 aur do 9 to nahi, different scores to nahi honge Anshu ke. Saurabh going from 24 to 48, differences of 24 same as Anand over here. Difference of 24 matlab agar maine 3 ka difference liya to 9 test mein alag score hai again, 10 mein nahi ho sakte hai na, we counted 27, 24, 27, 30, 33, 36, 39, 42, 45, 48 and then again ek aur test mein same hona padega. So Saurabh aur Anand bhi nahi ho sakte. Suhail 20 to 38, I think this possible 2k difference ke saath, 20, 21, 24, 26, 28, 30, 32, 34, 36, 38 hai. Suhail ka possible hai. Abhishek ka difference is of 20, so 2 se nahi hoga aur 4 se kam hi test mein itte difference nikal jayega aur Piyush ka bhi 18 hai, to Piyush mein bhi hoga. So Suhail and Piyush are the 2 people who could have got different scores in all the 10 tests. So my answer is going to be option 2 over here. This is the last question of this section, of this set. Which among the following is not a score that Abhishek could have got in any of the mentioned 10 tests? Abhishek, 24 to 44. So Abhishek, 24 to 44, difference of 20. So 4 ho sakta hai difference, 5 ho sakta hai difference. These are the only 2 cases, I guess. So 28, 32 are possible scores. 36, 40 is also a possible score. So ye do hata do. 5 ka difference lo agar. So 29, 32, 39 are possible scores. So 37 is not a possible score that Abhishek could have scored. Right? So comprehending this set was a bit difficult, but once done, I think it was easily doable. Let's just end the test and see our solutions now. We did in good amount of time, around 7 odd minutes, which is pretty good. Let's see the solutions of these 4 questions. Yes, perfect. We got the first one right. हम इसका आंसर की भी देख सकते हैं, थोड़ा लंबा है, एपी की आपकी फॉर्मूले लगाई हुई है इधर, ठीक है, बट ठीक है, व्हाट वी डिड वाज 100% करेक्ट. सेकंड वन वी गॉट इट राइट, थर्ड वन आल्सो वी गॉट इट राइट, क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 आल्सो वी गॉट इट राइट, व्हिच स्कोर इज नॉट पॉसिबल. राइट, सो वी गॉट ऑल द 4 क्वेश्चंस राइट. लेट्स जस्ट क्विकली गो थ्रू आवर लर्निंग्स फ्रॉम दिस सेट. ठीक है, लर्निंग्स इज अगेन मैथ is important. It's not that there are very complex, no very complex formulae or concepts of math are used, but at least yes, you should have the confidence, right? Confidence hona chahiye aapka, like in this case in arithmetic progressions. Needed to see the common difference and you had to divide it into equal parts and so on and so forth. So it was thoda sa challenging, right? So I would say this set was a bit challenging, but if you are comfortable with your arithmetic progressions, you could have done this set, okay? So if you are comfortable, it would be an easy to medium set. If you are not comfortable, it would be a medium to difficult set. So to each their own on this one, right? So yeah, that is what we have. We have our quants, which can be useful in LRDI as well. We've seen in the last 4 years, lot of mathematical reasoning questions coming in CAT rather than logical reasoning or data interpretation, which means lots of mathematical concept based solving happening in the sets in CAT. Right, let's come back and let's see the set for tomorrow. I don't want to forget showing you the set for tomorrow. Let's click on reattempts test. And yeah, this is the set. This is a 5-question set from questions 5 to question 9. This is the set, this is the data, this is the question. Take care. Show you the next question as well along with the data. This is the question, question number 6. Question number 7 is this. Take care. This is question number 7. 8 and 9. Okay, so we have 5 questions over here. Please try these questions, all of you, and we will see each other tomorrow. I will be trying to get into the chat section so that I can help you out if you have any doubts. And obviously, once I come back, if you have any doubts, we can always discuss them in our live sessions, or you can even come to my special classes on the Unacademy portal. Thank you so much for joining in today. It was, as always, an absolute pleasure to be doing the set for you guys, and I hope this gives you a good start of the day and you solve more sets throughout the day and you keep cracking it. Thank you so much. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.